Hello everyone, in this video we are going to design a helical barrel pinion that you can see on the screen right now. So now let us begin it. Let us go for the new part. After that go to the sketch and select the front plane. Now here we will first insert a horizontal center line, and now we will draw one sketch. So for that go to the line and we'll draw a sketch, that is the random sketch first. Now here we will insert a semicircle using the 3-point arc. Again go to the line and we'll complete the sketch. Now after that we'll give dimension. Go to the smart dimension. This length is of 45 mm, this is of 5 mm, this distance is 39 and this distance is 38. Now the radius of this circle is 11 and this distance is also 38. Now we will give the horizontal distances. For that first we will select this vertical line and this vertical line, and this distance is 158. Now the distance of this vertical line from this vertical line, this is 112 mm. Now the distance of this point from this line is 102 and this distance is 80 mm. So now our sketch is completed, and then exit the sketch, go to the features and select here the revolve boss feature and click on OK. Now we will insert the to reference geometry plane, and for that go to the reference geometry, select the plane and then select this face, and the distance is of 45 mm and OK. And again we insert another plane, and the distance from this plane is of 50 mm and OK. Now we will make the sketch on this plane. For that go to the sketch, select this plane. Now first we will draw a circle, and the diameter of circle is of 100 mm. After that we will draw two horizontal lines like this. And now we will insert a vertical center line. Then we will give it symmetric about this line, and for this line also, and make sure that this is vertical. Now we will give the distances. For that go to the smart dimension, and this horizontal distance is of 15 mm, it is 40 mm, and the distance of this line from the origin, that is 85 mm. Now we have to draw two arcs like this. And then go to the smart dimension, and the radius is 65 mm. Now we will make the pattern. For that select this three curve, then select here the circular pattern, and we have to make six such pattern. So here insert the six and then OK. Now we will remove some unwanted lines. For that go to the trim entities, and we will trim out these entities. and then we will exit this sketch. Now we have to also draw the sketches on other two planes also, and for that go to the sketch and select here this plane normal. Now here select the convert entities and select here this sketch. Okay, now here we'll click on this scale entities, then select this all entities. Now here we'll select the center point and the scaling factor is 0.75 and then okay. Now we'll revolve this sketch and for that go to the rotate entities, select this sketch. Now here center of rotation is of origin and we have to rotate the sketch by 15 degrees and then okay, and we'll exit the sketch. After that go to the sketch and we'll select here this plane normal, and again we have to do the same exercise. Select this sketch, bigger sketch, okay. After that we have to give the scaling, so here go to the scale entities, select all the entities. Now here we have to select the origin, this, and the scaling factor is 0.5 and then okay. Now we'll rotate. For that go to the rotate entities, then again select the sketch. Now we have to rotate it about the origin, so select the origin and the degree of rotation. Now it is 15 plus 15, so it is 30 and then okay. Now we'll exit the sketch. So our three sketches are completed. Now we'll go to the features and select here the lofted boss feature, and now we have to select the curves, and we'll select the curves and for the selection of the curve we have to see the corresponding points. For that first if we select this point, and for that we will select to see this, and for this we have to select this point and then okay. So now we will hide these two planes. Now we will go to the sketch and select this face, and now we will draw a circle with the diameter of 76. After that we will draw a horizontal line and here insert a vertical line and make sure it is vertical. Now go to the smart dimension and the length of this line is of 10 mm and we will make it symmetric about this vertical center line. Okay, and now we have to give the distance of this line from the origin, and for that we will mainly use the smart dimension, and here we will give the distance as a 43 mm. Now we will project the two vertical lines. Now we'll go to the trim entities and we'll trim these two. Okay, now we have to make the circular pattern for these three lines, and for that select these three lines, then select here the circular pattern, and we have to make 15 such sketch. For that here we will enter the 15. Okay, And now we have to trim unwanted portions. For that, go to the trim entities and we will trim out all this inner unwanted portion. And now we will exit this sketch. Then go to the features and select the extruded boss feature. And here we will select the offset. And here the offset distance is of 32 mm. And here we will reverse the direction. And the depth of extrusion for this sketch is of 48 mm. And here also we will reverse the direction and OK. Now select this part, go to the appearance and select the metal, steel. So now our part, that is the helical bevel pinion, is completed.